Youth Voices is a website that is a social network that we've been building in different ways over the past 10 years. On the site, students publish their own work, their digital work, and they learn how to respond to each other, and we learn from all of that. We know that there are many, many processes in learning to read and learning to do research, in taking texts apart, in the writing of something significant and important. How do you go from interest to deeper learning? Yes, there's a curriculum about the processes kids should do, but is there a content that they should do? Interest-based learning is so important in itself, and medieval times and Greek civilization and or whatever global history or whatever science curriculum or curriculum itself is also important. And so what happens when those things bump up against each other? And so those are the kinds of issues that we thought we could explore together in the summertime. But what we know in the writing project is that starting with yourself is really, really important.
Administrators, I think that they trust me to do things as I see fit, but sometimes I think that the issue is the how.
Like, what are the words, like, in Google, if you were going to search for that question, you'd be able to find that question. Okay, we'll get back to that, okay? Okay, so you may notice that we just gave you three assignments. So you're going to write three paragraphs about yourself. You're going to make an avatar or an icon. It can't be your likeness. It can't be a picture of you. 10 questions, real, real questions. Your neighborhood, your past, your future, your family. Deep questions, questions that you have about yourself. Then 10 questions about the world, could be religion, politics, big questions.
Do I have friends that are trustworthy?
What does the modern man think about the modern woman?
Are we actually being heard in society or ignored?
What will my profession be?
Why is bullying such a big issue?
Like their surroundings that they live in, how does that affect their decisions? And that will affect the way they live their life.
Why am I quiet when I should be loud?
Who invented language?
When will the government in Egypt stop murdering its people?
Do I still believe that there's such thing as bad people?
What kind of person do my friends portray me as?
When I had a chance to help my brother, why didn't I?
What is my identity?
How much longer will the indigenous people of Latin America continue to suffer because of their own wealth?
Doing the 10 self, 10 world questions, and then what we follow that with is immediately is coming up with 5 keywords for each question. And so that begins to give categories, gives categories for the questions.
My keyword, I put voices in society.
I put helping.
Reincarnation.
What's your topic?
Well, the question was, how much longer will the people, will the indigenous people of Latin America continue to suffer because of their own wealth?
Yeah. Did you try indigenous people?
How do we just teach them to like love learning?
I would probably start with the 10 world questions, because that probably gets them thinking about, you know, the world and like probably how our history has formed these questions for them or helped them think about these questions.
Reek was the student who I originally saw her researching about Egypt, because that's where her family.
So Reek, say your question again.
Mine was, when will the government in Egypt stop murdering its people?
But then when this whole story about Trayvon Martin and the the not guilty verdict came out, then she became interested in that.
Okay, you set Zimmerman free. What now? Well, like, what happens to like the rest? That just makes it to say that it's okay to shoot anybody that you think is suspicious. Might as well shoot me, because you know what? I have a scarf on. I might be a terrorist. Might as well shoot anyone else. You know what I mean? So if you set this guy free, you allow society to like do whatever they want. You know what I mean? There's got to be limits. There's got to be things. You know what I mean? That's just what I think.
What I guess concerns me, though, although I love the fact that she's studying something and she's learning something great about, you know, our process as a, you know, country and what we go through and how we find these things out, is that going to get her the skills that she's going
to
need?
How many of you have done free writing to make something? In other words, free writing, and then you did a focus sentence, and then you did more free writing, more free writing. After you do the free writing, we're going to ask you to do a focus sentence. And a focus sentence is totally the opposite of free writing. Free writing, you go wild, you follow tangents, you allow yourself to go anywhere you want to when you're writing. You'll start with your questions, your two or three questions, and you'll write as fast as you can. Not as fast, but non-stop. It doesn't have to be fast, but you shouldn't stop.
Maury was describing the beginnings of the research process and how free writes were used to inspire further examination and helped him actually get to a more focused
topic.
And then you talked about subtopics.
Yes. Like how your topic can lead to a subtopic. And then that subtopic you do research on will then lead to another, which was the process to get you to think, to get you to research more, to get you to learn more and more about your subject.
From the 10 self and 10 world questions, students develop
a triad of three questions.
We then had them look at the questions and see if they could chunk them into groups.
Then we want to deepen your inquiry, and there are two choices here. One is to find a video or a podcast audio about your topic. Can you talk a little more about the video you annotated?
It was a speech about Trayvon Martin that Obama gave.
I actually wanted to come out today is not to take questions, but to speak to an issue that obviously has gotten a lot of attention over the course of the last week, the issue of the Trayvon Martin ruling.
How is it different annotating that, right, in popcorn, or just watching a video, do you think?
I mean, annotating...
You watched it the first
time?
Yeah,
I watched it the first time, but like, I feel like once I got to annotate it, I like fully understood it even more because I had to like, you know, stop it, hear it again, and then annotate it. And then, like, make sure, like, the annotation goes with, like, the part of the video that I annotated. And I just feel like I fully understood it that way.
The other deeper way to go is we want you to think about finding more difficult texts. The way schools talk about this now is text complexity. So we want you to find a more complex text about your topic, okay?
So the last thing I wanted to ask you about this whole process is how does this differ? Maybe it doesn't, but how? What do you notice about this process and maybe the process that you use at school to write an essay?
At my school, we read books and then we write about a literary element about the book, what literary element we see that was processed in the book or used in the book, so we write about that. We learn more about technology. He taught us how to go on other websites and put them into Youth Voices. For example, with the Crocodoc, it's already in Youth Voices,
right.
But we learn how to do online annotation and finding videos, like here. I found a video on YouTube and I'm annotating it right here.
We want everybody to know that that's our goal. Your question in 3 to 5 cases.